Hello, second graders. Now, you remember the other day we heard the story of St. Patrick and how St. Patrick had traveled to find the most beautiful country. And when he got there, that the grasses were green and the sky was a beautiful blue and that there were rainbows in the sky. So today's painting is a bit of a choice painting. So on today's painting, I'm going to paint it first. I'll paint my version of the painting, and then you will paint after me. So watch the video of the painting first, and then you may choose what your most beautiful country looks like. You may choose to put the grass in at the bottom of your page. You may choose only to have the rainbows in the sky. You may choose to have beautiful blends of color. It is whatever you would like to paint for St. Patrick and the most beautiful country. So as you can see, I've started that I have all four of my colors opened. I have my clean water. I have my sponge. And I have my rag and my paper is wet. And I'm going to use my sponge very gently to take that extra water off the page. Now, I'm going to show you how to do green bushes if you want them at the bottom of your page and trees. You're going to start with your Prussian. So you go in that deep blue, right? And I'm going to think about what kind of grass I want. So I'm going to make my earth here. You see? So I know it looks like water right now, but I am going to make it into grass in just a minute. I'm going to paint it right across. Here we go. And once I have it right across, because I'm going to make it like rolling hills, it's going to be a bit of a scene. Then I'm going to clean my brush. I'm going to clean it really, really, really good because that Prussian, you know, if it gets in the lemon yellow, you will have mud. Green mud. Now you go in your lemon yellow. You want the pigment from the bottom, and then you can come in, and as you add that lemon yellow, you will see you get a nice, rich green. You can go right over the top of the Prussian to get that green. See? Now I have beautiful green. And I can make some trees later, but first I'm going to put my sky in. There we go. Now, for my sky, I want to add lots of colors to it. So I'm going to start with lemon yellow. And I'm just going to do a lemon yellow wash, just very even strokes with my hand from the left to the right until from the top of the page to the bottom has lemon yellow on it, very lightly. You don't need it to be super wet. You can take your time because you're going to add color. I'm going to add colors on top of that. I can see where I have a nice bump in my page, but that's all right. That happens sometimes. It may be happening at your house too. I'm going right from the left to the right. Back and forth, left to the right, nice even strokes. Now, as you get close to the green grass, you've got to go very lightly because you will get a little bit of green there. It's okay if you do, just go really lightly along the edge. Really lightly, you just want to not even quite touch. Now notice what happened there, do you see that? If I do that, if I get that on my page, you can take a very clean, dry brush. Make sure you dry it. Go right along the edge, just like I did in the classroom, and you can pick that right off. You see that? It takes a little bit of practice, so don't be frustrated if it doesn't happen perfectly the first time. All right? And I'm okay there because I might put a tree in that spot where I have a little bit of green. Now I have a beautiful sky. Now the next thing I'm going to add, I'm going to make my sky really colorful. So I'm going to add a little bit of lemon yellow. I'm going to come in with some strokes for lemon yellow, putting in my lemon yellow. Oh, my golden over my yellow, lemon yellow, I should have said. I'm gonna find some spots for there just to be lemon yellow and some spots for there to be golden too. There we go. I'm gonna put a little more golden at the bottom. Beautiful. I'm gonna clean my brush. And I'm gonna add some red. Now red, I went very light. I went in the top of my red, not into the pigment, to find that very light red. So you can do the same thing. You want the watery part at the top of the jar, not the thick color at the bottom. I'll show you what to do if you want the thick. But here's my beautiful sky. And my green grass is really nice and green. Now I'm going to add, I want a little bit of purple. So to get a little bit of purple, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in the pigment in the bottom. So I just have that deep pigment on the tip of my brush, and I have to decide before I put the brush on the paper where I want the purple. So I'm going to actually put my purple over here. So my darker red's going to go there. And I'm going to put my purple over here. And I can see I might need a little more red over there. There we go. Now I clean my brush. And then I can take the Prussian, the deep blue, and I can go over that red, and I should get a bit of a lilac. Yep, see, I've got a little lilac there. If you want more of a lilac, you add a little more red. Go gentle though, dab your brush in between so you don't end up with too much water. Ah, there we go. Now I can blend in a little bit of that purple. You can see I can really find that nice purple there in my sky. That's pretty lovely. I'm gonna add a little bit over here too, just a little bit. There we go. There we go. Well, I'm very happy with that sky. That looks lovely. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I would like to put a tree. So I'm going to go back into my Prussian, and from the bottom here I'm going to go up with my blue and I'm going to make the shape of a tree. Mine is going to be a bit of a pine tree, and you could see you could go the other way with your branches too. I'm going up with mine. You could go this way too with yours if you wanted, but I'm going to put mine here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull up the green so I can make a really beautiful tree there. A little more like a bush. That's okay. And then I can go into my green, I can put some grasses if I want them. Remember, you can choose how you do yours. I'm just taking a little brush making some grasses. Yeah, I can see where my tree looks a little bit more like a bush. There we go. Still, it has that nice green to it. I can even take a little bit of lemon yellow and put that in there. That's going to make it even more bush-like. So I think I'll make this, what started out as a tree, I'm just going to make it into a bush. Here we go. Oh, that looks nice and lovely. Then the other thing I can do if you want to, you have to go very carefully. Make sure you have a very dry brush. Take a little pigment on the very tip of your brush, something that looks like that. And then you dab it for flowers. And I'm going to work with red because red is the easiest one to work with. But my brush is very dry, and I went very much in the pigment at the bottom, just a little bit. And then I put a little bit of flowers. And you don't have to put flowers, but you can if you want. All right. And there I have my beautiful drawing of the land for St. Patrick. See how my painting right here got a little bit watery? I can always go back in and add a little bit more Prussian to that and just make that a little bit bluer, a little green, a little more green. That happens sometimes with paintings. You'll get a little splot like that if it dries. So just know that that can happen, and you can go right back in with a little bit of water and you can fix your as I have my bushes here, a beautiful bush. If I want to do a tree, I could do a tree. I'm gonna do more of a pine tree though. And you could do more of a pine tree here, or you can just leave it colors. You can just leave it the grass at the bottom, a few flowers, and just a beautiful colored sky, or even just a rainbow sky. It is your choice how you paint this beautiful painting for St. Patrick and the most beautiful country.